In this tutorial, I'll show you how to boolean a mesh multiple times at the same time by using the geometry nodes. Let's create a plane. I'll create a cube and scale it. This is how we boolean by using a modifier. Please remember the modifier recognized the cube scale values. Let's go to the geometry nodes. We need the mesh boolean node. Let's add the transform and the object info nodes. Do you see how the plane mesh has disappeared? That happened because the cube and the plane scale at the creation was identical. Unlike the Boolean modifier, the geometry nodes won't recognize the cube scale values. This means even if we scale the cube now, nothing will change. I'll add the join geometry node to show the original plane mesh as usual. The join geometry will override the Boolean status. Please don't use the join geometry node while using Boolean nodes. With the join geometry node active, nothing will change even if we change the transform node scale values. So far, I have shown you two important things to remember. One is how the cube scale status is being ignored, and another is why we shouldn't use the join geometry node with the mesh boolean node. Once we remove the join geometry node, we'll see the change right away. I had to add this part to the tutorial, because it took me a while to figure out what was going on when I first used the mesh boolean node. Please experiment with the transform values. If we select the cube, go to edit mode, and change the shape, Blender will recognize the new shape. There is the cylinder boolean. Let's add one more. Also, please watch out for the scale, Z, value, because if we lower it too much, we won't be able to see the result on the target mesh. To prevent this issue, please change the scale, Z, value. This is the end of the tutorial. Thank you for watching.